Hey guys, Dr. John Russin here, and what we're talking about today is functional direct arm training. Many times people forget that there's actually musculature in the arms that needs to be trained in order to make you strong and resilient, and direct arm training can actually lead to better compound strength numbers. Remembering that there's two different muscle bellies in the biceps group, and then three different muscle bellies in the triceps group. For pressing and pulling, these are secondary movers in those actions. Lindsay's gonna get down and actually get into a dumbbell bench press position, and we'll show exactly what we're talking about here. The prime mover in this position, especially out of the stretch, is gonna be the pectoralis group, but as Lindsay slowly presses up, the more and more she gets away from her center of mass and midline, the more that emphasis shifts to the anterior shoulder and then also the triceps. The same thing could be said on the opposite side of things with any pulling-based movements. Lindsay's gonna set up here in a traditional single-arm dumbbell row, and we're gonna see the same thing. Primary mover here is gonna be the latissimus, but also the upper back group, but really ending up that range of motion at the top, at terminal end range, is the biceps contracting here. This could be also said for the vertical plane of motion. Just keep in mind that direct arm training can transfer into better strength numbers in the compound lifts.